Rikimaru, Master Shionsai calls us.
On my way.
What are you two doing here?
My students, rebellion has broken out in the House of Goda. Our honorable Lord Goda is in danger from his own uncle, Sire Motohide. If the Lord we serve falls to a dishonorable traitor, we, Azuma Ninja, will stand for nothing. Go to Goda Castle and protect Lord Goda with your lives.
We're here to help.
Oh, thank goodness. His lordship is still inside. So are Lady Kay and Princess Kiku.
Let's go.
Ayame, find Lady Kay and the princess. Rikimaru, come with me. We must rescue Lord Goda.
Wait. Rikimaru, go find his lordship. I'll catch up later.
Welcome back to Let's Play Tenchu, Birth of the Stealth Assassins. Last time, we completed Ayame's mission, and now we're playing as her partner, Rikimaru, where we're going to see all the events that happened on his side of the story. There is a traitor. Lord Goda's own uncle, Motohide, has betrayed us, sending in all of his troops to kill our people. We can't have this. Where is he? I'm going to seek him out and destroy him. We are a ninja. We're going to use the element of surprise. Not only is Rikimaru sneaking up on all of his enemies, but he's also hiding his sword behind his back. Just so they'll never suspect a thing. Nasty. So, this is the first video I'm shooting after Christmas, and I'll probably post it after the new year. Happy Christmas, happy new year, everybody. Let's kill people. What a great way to start the year. I had an excellent Christmas. I went to my granddad's house and my mum cooked an amazing dinner. I stuffed my face and then proceeded to eat lots of chocolate as well. Because chocolate's good. There were loads of presents. And because I've got a job, I bought some of them. I must admit, I'm not incredibly imaginative when it comes to presents. I got my dad The Walking Dead Season 2 on Blu-ray. To go with his Walking Dead Season 1 Blu-ray I got him a couple of years ago. Some memory foam slippers. And also some Ferrero Rocher chocolates. Because I thought he would like that. And I think he did. For my mother, I got her some perfume I know that she likes. More Ferrero Rochers. Some for Dad, some for Mum. And I know that she likes her cookbooks. So I got her one of those. Which brings me to my sisters. For them, I got the exact same presents. Some chocolate, and also more perfume. But this perfume is stuff that I know that they like, and it was incredibly hard to get hold of. I searched all around town, and nowhere had it. And I thought, oh no, I really wanted to get them that, because that was my only idea. Something I know that they actually want, and I can't find it. But then, I found it in the shops. This one shop had it. And they said,
oh yes, well, give us your address and we'll post it to you.
So I gave them the details, I paid for it. I thought, great, it's all sorted out. Then a few days later, I got an email saying, sorry, we don't have it in stock, you've been refunded. Oh, thanks a lot. So I still need to go and find it. Once again, eBay saved my life. Thank you, eBay. I got everything done and there were no tears at Christmas. And as for me, I'm awkward. Chris, what do you want for Christmas?
I don't know.
So yeah, I was very unhelpful in that department.
So I got loads and loads of money.
And it's all hidden in a secret place where no one will ever, ever find it. Because that's the problem when you have a job. You kind of spend all your money on stuff that you want anyway. And you know me. I don't go out drinking. I don't spend my money on stuff like that. I spend my money on sensible things like Doctor Who toys for my stop motion, which I just posted. And that seemed to give my family an idea of what to get me for Christmas. So I got more Doctor Who toys.
And I love them. They're brilliant.
I'm very amused by things like that. I think it's good, though, to have something that interests you because, well, when I think of what to buy for my nan for Christmas, I'm out of ideas completely because she doesn't have any hobbies. She doesn't embrace new technology. She's still stuck in the VHS era. She'd rather use TV magazines than actually use the TV guide on her TV. She uses disposable cameras and she refuses to acknowledge the existence of computers. All my nan does is sits around watching terrible TV.
Nice to see you.
Shut up. This is what I think of your stupid scripted reality shows. Rigged talent contests. People standing around pretending to be nice to each other.
I've never met you before, but I'm really going to miss you. You're a lovely person.
And as for Noel Edmonds' box game, I bet there are no rules. He's making it up as he goes along. And that's why I think for next Christmas, I should buy my nan tons and tons and tons of horror films. On VHS. Either that or just a Christmas card. Anyway, where am I?
Oh yeah.
I forgot I was playing this game. Dead people. Speaking of dead people, I've done pretty well for myself not dying myself at work. Because over Christmas, people have been walking past me going, and furthermore, and it's disgusting. They never put their hand over their mouths. And there's me thinking, I'm not being ill over Christmas. It was good. I had loads and loads of extra Christmas hours, more money, and I spent a lot of that time trying to dodge all these sick people, because there's nothing worse than when it's Christmas time and you can't really enjoy it because you're ill. But I'm happy to say I got through it and I didn't catch a cold. Sorry! Also, I've been compiling the home video footage, the family stuff, throughout the year. And 2013 has been chronicled. That's the good thing, because you can get rid of all the rubbish you don't want to keep and have only the interesting bits. And I've edited my family videos in a way which, as I'm sure you can imagine, is pretty silly. I do it as if I'm making a video for you guys. And why should it be serious? That's my problem with photographs. They don't show the real you. If you're all in a photograph, smiling, yes, it's all very nice, all presentable.
Isn't that a lovely picture?
It's nice to have a lovely picture, but it doesn't show you being you. That's why video is the way forward.
I want to be remembered as the nutter I am.
The world is torn apart by war. I am the House of Goda's only hope. The peasants must learn their place.
You're wrong, Uncle. The people are the soul of this land.
Enough! Die! Compassionate fool.
My lord!
Oh no! Lord God has been shot! Haven't you watched The Lion King? Evil uncles cannot be trusted. Well, it's looking good. I have him cornered. You, sir, are going to die. Ah! Oh, no. That's not good. Where's Lord Goda anyway? He's disappeared. But don't worry. I won't let Motohide get away with this. Oh, it's over.
How humiliating. Defeated by a servant.
Sire Motohide, prepare to die.
What? Goda, you fool. Now you've been shot and stabbed.
Lord Goda.
Identify yourself, ninja.
Rikimaru of the Izuma Ninja, my lord.
I recognize you now.
My lord, I tried to kill the traitor, but I have dishonored myself by striking you.
Nonsense. You did not mean to injure me. My uncle, he is misguided. But he's trying to save the land.
Assassin!
Jubei, stop! It's Rikimaru! He saved my life!
Rikimaru? The ruffian Master Shiunsai was training. Well, you have my thanks. But my lord, Motohide's soldiers are broken into the castle. You must flee. Use the secret exit.
I will not leave the castle while my wife and daughter are still here.
Please, my lord, they'll kill you!
Lady Kay and Princess Kiku are in good hands. Ayame went to rescue them. My lord, what of the people? What will become of them if you die today?
Die! My lord, I beg you, take the secret passage. Rikimaru, protect him. Go. I can't hold them off forever.
Okay. Great. So we got Grand Master. We weren't spotted, and we got 15 stealth kills.
Oh, my castle burns. All is lost. If only these tears could quench the flames.
My lord.
What a pathetic being I have become.
Yep. Solid Snake would not approve. What a weird-looking horse.
Lord Goda, are you all right?
Sekia, I am glad to see you alive.
You must be Rikimaru. Jubei told me how you saved Lord Goda's life. I am in your debt.
Saved? It was my sword that...
Sekia, where are Kei and Kiku?
Oh, my lord. They,
What is it? Tell me!
My lord, I regret to inform you that your wife, Lady Kei, has been killed. And your daughter, Princess Kiku, kidnapped. Ayame is chasing the kidnapper. But my lord, the kidnapper, the murderer, is your uncle, Motohide.
What? Motohide? It is my fault, my lord. I should have been there.
It is no fault of yours, Rikimaru. The blame is mine, and I must bear it alone.
My lord.
My lord. The enemy has taken advantage of the rebellion to move against us. Toda's troops have crossed our border. What is your command?
Toda thinks my uncle's treason leaves us helpless? I'll kill that coward myself!
I will find Toda, my lord, and bring you his head.
Rikimaru?
Please, my lord, if you die this day, Sire Motohide will rule.
Toda! Your time is at hand!
One of these days, Rikimaru is going to give away his position by shouting into the darkness. It's just not very ninja-like. It's like when Solid Snake is surrounded by enemies and decides to have a nice little conversation on his codec. No one but him will be able to hear it, but surely they can hear him talking, apparently to himself. On that note, I always find it weird when people have Bluetooth devices, because you know where you are when people have a phone in their hands, they're talking on the phone. But when people have things in their ear you can't see, they're just walking around talking to no one, you just think, oh dear. It's one of those nutters. Whatever we do, let's be polite and don't make eye contact. Well, I admit I have met my fair share of genuine nutters. I seem to attract them. I'm sure there are some of you watching the video right now. Hello! Well, don't worry, because together we are safe. Together we are strong, and we shall rise! Be nutters together and worship a pine cone or something. It'd be brilliant! Those that oppose us shall be doomed to a life of normality.
Who says what's normal?
Well, obviously the majority. But the majority, the normal people, might have it all wrong. If you're going to walk around appearing as though you're talking to yourself whilst actually speaking on a Bluetooth device, then you're a poser. You need to get a real imaginary friend. If you like, I shall be your imaginary friend. I shall be the disembodied voice that you speak to. I am, after all, providing one side of a conversation, and if I have a great argument, I've got no one here to bounce off of, no one to disagree with me, and it's brilliant! But if my videos do inevitably change the way that you live, then I think that I should hear about it. Feel free to talk back to me. I might not hear what you say, but I can certainly read your comments. And comments are good. And I believe that we're near the end of the level.
Zaku, the Red Sparrow. You may not pass beyond this.
Stand aside!
What's your hurry, hero? Stay and play.
Ah, here we go! This is my favorite antagonist in this entire game, Suzaku. Another character with a familiar voice to players of Metal Gear Solid, because this was the original voice of Gray Fox. And this character is totally evil. I remember he has some brilliant lines. Hey! How dare you? Laying down a smoke bomb. Well, this is one of the four lords of the Burning Dawn, and I'm not going to let him live. Sorry, Suzaku, the Red Sparrow. Time to die. Or not.
You're good, little ninja. One day you might actually become a worthy opponent for me.
Come back!
Forget it. I've got to stop Tota. I'll get Suzaku some other day. Looks like you paid a high price for your treason, Sayamoto.
Tota!
You beat me to him. Ayame? No, such a clean cut. It must have been Tetsumaru.
Oh no! Rikimaru, protect Princess Kiku!
Tatsumaru! We got through that level like an expert.
3 months have passed. Goda Castle was saved by a well-timed rain shower, just as the House of Goda was saved by the Azuma Ninja. While loyal subjects repair the castle, Lord Goda recovers from his wounds in the Azuma Ninja village. All seems well, but the village's heart is heavy, for there has been no news of Tatsumaru.
Terrible news from one of our mountain villages. People are disappearing. The terrified villagers whisper that demons have come for them. Go there and stop this tragedy.
As you command, my lord.
Help! Somebody help me!
Go ahead and scream. We're in the middle of nowhere. Ain't nobody gonna hear you or care.
Please, somebody!
You're a pretty sad excuse for a demon.
Who are you?
I am the man who will cut off your nose at the neck.
Oh, you see, this is what I mean. Nutters. Now in intimidating-looking costumes. You see, this is why I've never been to Disneyland. Not because I've not been abroad before, but because deep down I've always had this fear of being hugged by Mickey Mouse. Like in the adverts. I just feel that all is not right with the world when you have a 7-foot mouse looming over you. I guess that's why you don't see many clowns anymore, because in this day and age, people that walk around looking like this guy, no matter how innocent and pure their intents may be, they have no place in the world. Because more people seem to think of clowns as psychotic killers than funny entertainers. How sad. People probably find killer clowns more entertaining than actual clowns because you never know where you are with an actual clown. You're thinking, what's he gonna do with that balloon? What's he doing? He's made a draft. And so you see, it was all innocent after all. So you can take the balloon home, everything's fine. After all, what's the worst thing that can happen with a balloon animal? Nothing. Up until the point where the balloon pops, revealing within a homing device. You look up at your bedroom window to see the clown staring at you with a look of hunger in his eyes. Luckily though, we know exactly where we are with these clowns. These clowns are all evil. That's why they must die. Now, watch this. Nearly. I quite like their long-nosed masks. Sort of reminds me of what Alex wears in A Clockwork Orange. Although, I'm not so sure about all the colour they're wearing. I'm with Rikimaru on this one. Let's wear black. Colours, fashions, they come and go because people realise that they look stupid after a while, but black always looks good. It's like an orchestra, timeless, it looks good with everything. I think we should all go back to a 19th century look and wear long coats and top hats, because that would be brilliant. And canes, got to have a cane. Maybe a monocle. Bet this is ancient Japan, where everybody's got weird trousers on. Sorry, bear. I didn't want to do that to the bear. It was just a reaction. I saw it moving. I thought, it's a thing, and it's moving. It's a moving thing. Let's kill it. And ask questions later. I know I can't say anything that can change the fact that I just killed a poor innocent teddy bear, but I'll distract you. Toast! There. I distracted you with toast, which I believe makes everything right again. Now where am I? Uh-oh, it's a person.
Hide!
That's right, you face away from me. No, don't come out. Go away! With your big nose. Oh, two of them. I sure hope he doesn't notice this badly concealed sword. Okay. That's one. And we've got another one over there. Quick!
Hide! Oh no! No.
Make sure he doesn't see me. Where is he? He's seen a dead body, but he's not seen me. So it's okay. Let's get a bit closer. What? Someone else is... Stop looking at me! I don't make these videos to be looked at! This is an audio adventure with a visual aid. Just think, people can listen to me jabbering away about important things. Ranting about the stuff that matters. It's all about the commentary. If it wasn't about the commentary, you'd watch a video with no commentary and focus on the game. So you can fall asleep listening to this. And learn something.
There shall be a questionnaire in the video description.
Oh, the end of the level.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Here, you might need this.
That'll teach you to run away, peasant.
You coward. He had no weapon.
He's a peasant, an insect.
Insects are better than you, you murderer.
Oh, look. It's a guy with an annoying voice. Listen, mate, there's you, there's me, and this place is getting overcrowded. So here he is, the demon ninja of the Burning Dawn. Ha! And I've just knocked him off the bridge. Come on, come back up here. I'm waiting. Where is he? Are you just waiting down there? Well, if you will not come to me, then I shall come to you.
Hi!
Ow. Whoa! You made my head glitch through the wall. How dare you? Okay, next time I get a packet of something saying, great for sharing, you're not getting any. Now there's anyone else, but I just want to make that absolutely clear that you're not getting any, and I need to cure because I'm dying. You backstabber! Where's he gone?
I'm being chased by an evil demon clown.
Come on, knock him off. Aww. So close.
You shall die in silence.
Nasty. And Rikimaru completed his mission like a master ninja.
Take this.
What is it?
Their map. It shows their secret harbor. Please save our village.
Your death will not be in vain. I, Rikimaru, swear it. I've got to save those villagers. What is that?
Sometimes in Rikimaru's voice, you can really hear the Peter Parker coming out. Oh yes, he voiced Spider-Man. Also, he did Lewis in Resident Evil 4. What an all-star cast. And in this level, we're going to meet another character, whose voice we may recognize. Now, we have to be very careful in this terrain. Guards could be sneaking out from all corners. Now, where's this guy going?
Ah!
There's another one close by. But where? There he is. A gunman.
No, good.
That was close. But not quite close enough. We were lucky. So, here we are in the secret harbor. We have to save the villagers and make our way to the boats. But first, I'm going to get rid of this guy, because he bothers me. That was brilliant! Oh, another guy. Let's get him before he hides himself in darkness.
Sorry.
Ow. He did it again. What have I told you about dying in the animation, falling to the ground, and then suddenly springing back up again? It's weird. Stop it! What's this guy doing?
Uh-oh. He can see me.
Go away. Okay, let's go.
Oh no! Sorry, I panicked.
But he didn't see me. I'm still a stealth ninja assassin extraordinaire. For all the noise I make, everyone is totally oblivious. Who's next? Anyone?
Oh, someone's nearby.
It's a beautiful lady. Hello. Oh.
Sorry.
Never mind. I'm sure one day she'll forgive me. We'll get married and have two wonderful children called Zenith and Quasar. And by the way, iceberg lettuce is really, really nice. Thing is, I work in a shop. A shop? It's good working in a shop, but it's one of those shops that doesn't sell food. It sells chocolate. Yummiful, tempting chocolate. So, to stop myself from buying junk food all the time, I'm stocking up on iceberg lettuce. It's a nice snack, and when you look at the ingredients, it says 100% lettuce, as opposed to everything else I'd buy. I tried to buy a healthy-looking drink, and then I read the ingredients. It said 2% apple, 2% grape, 2% something else, and sugar. The picture on the front lies. I can't keep my ninja-like physique if I constantly eat junk food.
So, Rikimaru,
we must eat rabbit food and get plenty of exercise and kill lots of people. Here we are at the end of the level. Now, listen to this guy's voice.
Metal Gear Solid fans may recognize the vocal cadences of Raiden.
Thank you for saving us.
Hurry, get out of here!
Not him.
Rude person. In China, guests not leave without thanking hosts.
This guy.
Ah, but you are my guest while you are in Japan, and you have overstayed your welcome.
Here we go.
Boss time.
So, this is the son of the man who was enslaving people, who was defeated by Ayame. And now he shall be defeated by Rikimaru. Because he's cornered. Ha!
Oh no, now I'm cornered. Ah! Help!
Where's he gone?
Oh, there he is. Hello!
He doesn't have a weapon. He's using fists against my sword. What an idiot!
Goodbye.
Defeated by barbarian dog. I'm sorry, father.
Level complete, and we did that like a master ninja. I'm gonna end the video, but first, time for a cutscene.
Who are you?
Your worst nightmare.
That blade, that's Izayoi. Tatsumaru, you're alive.
Who's Tatsumaru? I am Seiru, the Blue Dragon, one of the four lords of the Burning Dawn.
Burning Dawn? What are you talking about? You're Tatsumaru, leader of the Azuma Ninja.
I have no time to talk to a madman.
Tatsumaru! It's me! Rikimaru!
So, Tatsumaru survived the fall.
But how could the enemy trick him into joining them?
Tatsumaru would never fall for a simple trick. There are unseen forces at work.
Master, could it be that he's forgotten who he is?
Even if that is so, we still bear responsibility for his actions. If he has dishonored himself, only death at the hands of an Azuma ninja will purify him. You must be prepared to kill him.
Shunsai!
The temple has been overrun. Some group called the Burning Dawn.
Burning Dawn?
You've heard of them?
I...
Rikimaru, your answers lie within the temple. Go now and find the truth.
Hurry, we're counting on you.
Yes, my lord. I'll get answers all right. With cold steel.